أَنزَلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We talked about Abraham alayhi salam and the relationship with his father, and then also the reality of his spiritual journey, coming close to God and coming from one light to a higher light, to the light and understanding the light beyond the light and the light upon light. Now, as we are following history, we come to other major figures. Of course, we have Yaqub and Yusuf, Joseph, that we have in the Quran, and the stories that we have here. Of course, we can't talk about everything in 30 lessons because it's too short, and it's very difficult to have and to go to details. What we're trying to get through this history is the main figures and the main teachings for us, the way we understand them, and in which way this could have an impact on us today. One of the main figures, of course, is Yaqub alayhi salam, in the way he was dealing with the message and the way he was dealing with his own family, his own sons and children. We have this story in the Quran, and we have in Surah Yusuf, Joseph, the Surah 12, the whole story narrated. And we'll just take two stories out of this session, and the next episode we'll try to get the meaning and try to draw some teachings for us and getting a deeper understanding of the Quran. What we find at the beginning of Surah Yusuf is the following. بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحن نقص عليك أحسن القصص بما أوحينا إليك هذا القرآن وإن كنت من قبله لمن الغافلين إذ قال يوسف لأبيه يا أبت إني رأيت أحد عشر كوكبا والشمس والقمر رأيتهم لي ساجدين قال يا بني لا تقصص رؤياك على إخوتك فيكيدوا لك كيدا إن الشيطان للإنسان عدو مبين. What we find here is we narrated to you the most accurate history by revealing to you this Quran, although prior to it you were of the unaware. When Joseph said to his father, O my father, I saw 11 planets or stars, and the sun and the moon, I saw them bowing down to me. He said, O my son, do not relate your vision to your brothers, lest they plot and scheme against you. Satan, the devil, is man's sworn enemy. This story, the beginning of Surah Yusuf, it's important and it's very deep in the way we can understand the very essence of the Quran. When it is said, we narrate to you the most accurate story, it's you didn't know these stories. You didn't know what happened before you. So the Quran is coming to you to reveal to you the stories of the messengers and the prophets, peace be upon them, who came before you, for you to get the knowledge, not only to get the knowledge of what happened to them, but also to draw the spiritual teachings for you today. So once again, we get the very essence of the Quran for us today. Read the Quran to know what happened and to learn how to deal with the challenges that you are facing in your daily life. So this is the twofold dimension of the Quran in your life, and this is also said to the Prophet والسلام, because you were min al-ghafirin, you were unaware of what happened to them, so you don't know. But if you learn, if you get the knowledge of what they went through, you will understand what is happening to you. You will understand what is your destiny. You will understand that what is happening to you, it's not new. And for us today, in the way we deal with Al-Quran and the way we deal with the Prophet's life, والسلام, it's also for us to get it right, that what happened to the Prophet والسلام, and to the companions, it's also things that we are facing. And then, after this, this introduction, there is the story of Yusuf telling to his father one of his dreams. I saw, you know, planets, I saw stars, and 11 of them, and the sun and the moon, they were prostrating, bowing to me. Bowing to me mean that I saw that I had a very special place and something was happening there. Straight away, Jacob straight away understood. So here he is telling him a dream and he got the message. Yaqub got the message. And this is the very special relationship, spiritual relationship Yaqub had with his son Yusuf alayhi salam. And from this you can understand that something was very, very deep between them. Of course, it was not exactly the same with the other brothers and the brothers of Yusuf's brothers. But the reality here is this very special communication that they had through their faith in Allah, the way they were trusting God. Because in fact, through the dream, what Yaqub is saying to his son, it's great what you saw. They were prostrating, but it means that something not good is going to happen. Don't talk about it to your brothers, because they will plot, they will act against you. Meaning the great vision that you had is also now announcing something that is going to be a test, a trial for you. Out of this story, there are at least three teachings that we should get out of this story. The first one is the very place and the very essence of dream. In fact, there is a communication through our dreams. Yes, when we sleep, it's as if we are entering into a small death. But while we are dealing with our subconscious, with our unconscious reality, God is talking to us. So we know this by the way we go, and sometimes Salat al-Istikhara that we are making just to get things that are coming from God before going to sleep. Dreams are important as to our communication with the invisible world and our communication with God. Things are coming through, and the way we can see the Prophet, the way we can see signs in our dreams. So we have to be aware. We have to know that not only there is this rational communication which makes you now listen to me, there is not an irrational but non-rational communication coming from the invisible world, coming from our dreams. And it's not only psychoanalysis, it's not only psychology that we're talking or are talking about it. Islam and all the religious tradition, even the spiritual Asian African traditions, are talking about dreams, because there is something here that we got. It's not only our brain functioning, it's our inner world expressing, translating, and this is what happened. There is also something else which is predicting the future, and this is what happened to Yusuf alayhi salam, that he got a vision of something that was going to happen symbolically. And also this is also the power that we can get out of some revelation that God is, or ilham, inspiration that God can give us through dreams. And we need also to be aware that could happen. The last thing which is important is that Yaqub got the message and he told his son, don't speak about this. As if, you know, this is the secret between God and you and me, because you told me the dream. Meaning that sometimes in your spiritual journey, when you got something, when you feel something, when you experience something, you better keep quiet. You better remain silent, because it's not the time to talk. It might be that you are going to talk too fast, too quickly, and you will not get the message. And this is exactly what happened with Yusuf alayhi salam. Don't talk about it. And then with the story coming, and then your brothers are going to understand what they can't get now, they will get it tomorrow. And that's very important, that you may have some knowledge without words. Wait for the words to translate the knowledge, because at that time you will be able to understand the knowledge through the words. So silence is also something which has to do with the spiritual journey, even in the way we deal with our dreams, even in the way we deal with our feelings and our relationship with God. That's something which is important for us now, and that we got through the story of Yusuf alayhi salam. Don't forget to tell the people you love that you love them. Life is fragile.